Well, there are growing concerns this morning that Greece is heading for financial collapse and it could impact the entire world. The country has now taken the extreme step of ordering the closure of its banks. So could this crisis affect us? To talk about it, we have Paul Bloxham, who is the chief economist at HSBC. Paul, thanks for coming in.
Hello, Paul.
So, Paul, Greece has shut its banks and instated capital controls. In layman's terms, what does that mean? Are we all in big trouble?
Well, it means that the Greeks can't get any money out of their banks at the moment. That's what's happened. Because there's such a run and people want to get the hold of their money, and, of course, the government's got such high levels of debt and it's unable to service that debt, people are going to the banks trying to get their money out, but they're unable to do that. That's one of the first steps they're taking in this process, which is probably going to take a little while yet to work out.
Is it going to work, do you think?
Well, the question is, what do you mean by work, in a way? Yeah. Greece is part of the euro area.
Yeah, that's right. So the ramifications are quite high.
Sure. So there are options here. They may stay in the euro if they can continue to come up with a negotiating strategy with their creditors. So really the story here is the Greeks have borrowed a lot of money from the rest of the world. Right. Particularly they borrowed money from the IMF and the European Union. And they've got so much debt that they're unable to continue to service that debt. Mm. And so what they've had to do, actually, is borrow even more money to service that debt. Now, when they borrowed that money to keep paying the servicing, they took some conditions on, but they're not prepared to meet those conditions anymore. And that's really where we're at now. They're saying, no, those conditions are too hard. We can't do that. And so they're being forced to make a decision.
Because that's the real problem here, isn't it? They've elected this hardcore socialist government and it's just said, no, actually, we're not going to make any of the cuts. We're not going to cut the pension. We're not going to cut public service jobs and do all the things that the Europeans need them to do in order to be able to become a functioning economy again. They've just said, no, we won't play. Is that right?
Well, in order to stay part of the euro, they've said, no, they won't accept all of these conditions that have been put in place.
How did it actually get to this crisis? How did it get so far?
Well, fundamentally, the story here is the government was spending lots of money and wasn't getting enough tax revenue, and so their debts rose. And if you look at how much debt they've got, their debt is 170% of their GDP at the moment. If you make a comparison with Australia, you know, our debt is 30% of our GDP. And we talk about, you know, the fact that we would like to try and lower it and there's a challenge there and so on. But they're 170% of their GDP.
So we've handled the debt crisis correctly, have we?
Oh, we're in a lot better shape than a place like Greece, a lot better shape. And, of course, that's why Greece is a critical part of the news right now.
Mm-hmm. How do you think it will affect us here in Australia? I mean, I think about people in Greece suddenly not being able to take the money out of their banks and you would just panic. What will there be a trickle-down effect here?
Sure. It should be a pretty small deal for Australia. We're talking about a small country. We're talking about a country that's got 12 million people on the other side of the world with 1% of European GDP. And sure, they've got some enormous challenges there, but it's got pretty limited ties to Australia in the scheme of things, economic ties at least. But because, of course, it's part of the euro area, because they all have the same currency, the risk is that if something happens, if this Greek story doesn't play out well, the rest of the European area might have some challenges. Other countries might say, look, I don't want to meet the conditions either. I don't want to necessarily pay my share. And that's the risk. That's what the markets are very worried about right now.
Domino effect.
So that's right. And that would be a big story for Europe. But once again, I mean, our story in Australia is strong ties to China. We have got our major trading partners are in Asia, and that's been one of the things that's been the key success for Australia in recent years.
Paul, thanks for coming in to talk to us about this.
No problem.
Scary stuff. If you are travelling to Greece and are worried at all, head to smarttraveller.gov.au for updates and information.